Chamberlan, this is not necessarily a controversial subject, but the flag and statues, is that a big deterrent to development?
It is. You know, we have a lot of things going well for us in the state. We're a right-to-work state, non-union state. We have really good access to labor and land. And so we're teed up very well for a lot of big manufacturing, a lot of businesses to come here. The problem is when they run into social issues that prohibit them from coming to our state. And it's more than time to change that. As someone who grew up in the state of Mississippi, loves this state, happy to call it home, I understand, because even as a kid, I didn't grow up in a period where the Confederate flag, you know, when I was growing up, it was Dukes of Hazzard and football games, per se. So, you know, I think a lot of people like myself in their early 40s probably have fond memories of growing up and seeing that. However, as you grow up and you realize the significance of what that flag meant and what it means to others in this state, I think it is more than time for us to make that change.
You know, I noticed a survey that was just out maybe yesterday, and I can't remember the exact percentages, but there was 1% difference between those that said change the flag to those that said don't change the flag to those that said I really don't know.
Yeah.
You know, it was like 3% from top to bottom.
I don't trust too many polls these days,
yeah.
Regardless, but I hope it sounds like our legislators are really taking up the issue, and that if they can come to a consensus, our governor will not stand in the way of that change. And I commend all of the officials that are making those hard decisions today, because I do know that as an elected official, you represent all of your people, regardless if you agree with them or not. And there are a lot of people that hold a lot of heritage and have a lot of emotions around the flag. And so I understand that that's a tough decision. But I think in our current environment and with the opportunities we have in front of us, but mostly important that we're the most diverse state in the nation. You know, we have the highest percentage of African Americans in our state. And I think knowing that, we have to be respectful and come up with a flag that the entire state, all of our population, can get behind.
Well, there's one thing that's a fact. It's not going away.
It's not going away.
Right? It's not going away. So, you know, you heard the song, change is going to come or whatever. Something is going to happen, and I think it's only going to be more painful in all economic aspect of it to the social aspect of it down the road than if we face it right now.
I couldn't agree more, and you hear a lot of arguments for this should be put in front of the voters in November, and I can understand that to a certain degree, but to that point, I think in the environment we're in today, that is a risk we can't take, because as Mississippians, we don't need to go through every other day hearing from the NCAA, hearing from corporations that are boycotting our state, and simply for us to say, oh, we're going to address it in November. I think if we sit from now into November and take that beating from every corporation, from everyone telling us what to do, it just diminishes Mississippi more. But we have the opportunity to take control of it and be a leader and say, Mississippi's open for business. Mississippi's not the old divisionary Mississippi. We're a state of unification and diversity, and we celebrate that. I think you're going to see a world of opportunities develop, which then will trickle down to all Mississippians.
601-261-0898, just about out of time. Chamberlan, if someone is interested in apartments, economic development, real estate, or something like that, how do they get in touch with you or some of your people?
You know, the best way to do it is just to pick up the phone. We always love having those conversations. You can reach us at 601-264-4622. Or check us out on the web at southgaterealtyllc.com for all commercial real estate needs. And on the apartment front, you can always look at us on hattiesburgapartments.com.
Do you have anything on the drawing board right now that you're looking down the road developing?
Not right now. I think we are still in a phase of making adjustments to the way we manage and knowing that those adjustments are going to be continuous over the next 18 to 24 months. Not to say that there's not opportunities for development. I don't think that they're in our typical wheelhouse. I think you're going to see a lot of opportunities for industrial growth throughout an economic or COVID issue, but things like multifamily and retail and office, I think we're more in a wait and see approach.
Chamberlan Carothers, good friend, good businessman, great Hattiesburg, greater development person as well. Thanks for joining us this morning. I look forward to talking again, Chamberlan.
Thanks for having me, Ted. Enjoyed it.
Thank you very much. Chamberlan Carothers. Fox News is next. We'll have the weather in a moment.